I would like to request Dr. Preetam to share the slides and please address the participants.
Thank you, Dr. Neelam, for giving me this wonderful opportunity. And good morning, each and everyone. I would especially thank Professor Cheng for giving his wonderful presentation. I would also like to thank Professor Manoj Saini, Department of Mathematics of PDPU, and all the attendees who are here. So yeah, just give me a minute. I would just like to share my slides right now.
Sure.
A very good morning once again. My today's presentation topic is on fractional order PID controller to reduce frequency mitigations. This can be actually thought as a continuation to what Professor Cheng has already presented. So this is the basic introduction of fractional calculus. So before fractional calculus was introduced, so this fractional calculus can be thought as an extension of calculus. And as you know, even though a small traces of calculus can be found in the early India, Greek, China, and medieval Europe, the formal introduction to this calculus was actually developed by Sir Isaac Newton and Leibniz, which date back to 17th century. And in the 17th century itself, this fractional calculus was introduced. And since then, calculus has become an integral part of many developments that are used in day-to-day life. So calculus basically has two subdivisions, that is the integral and differential calculus, which are the mathematical study of integer order integration and differentiation of functions respectively. So in the same century, mathematicians like Laplace has thought about the half derivative of a function and wrote a same letter to Leibniz about the same. Since then, many renowned mathematicians such as Riemann, Abel, Lavoisier, and etc. has contributed to this particular field. But only after the year 1970, the conference particularly emphasized on fractional calculus were held, and one of the primary reasons to was due to the works of Professor B. Ross. And after this, the first conference on fractional calculus which can be traced back to 1974 was held in New Haven, so with proceedings edited by Professor Ross itself. So basically, in fractional calculus, it is a study that deals with various properties of derivatives and integrals of arbitrary order. And there are so many definitions of fractional order operators, and some of them are Riemann-Lavoisier fractional operator, Caputo fractional operators, Grunwald-Retnikoff fractional operators, etc. And one of the preliminary introduction to these fractional operators were given given by both Lehmann and Lavoisier. And even though there are so many fractional order derivatives which were fractional order operators introduced, one of the widely used fractional operators are the Caputo fractional operators, since it has a practical applicability and it has a wider domain for applicability and practical problems. So in Caputo fractional or fractional operators, the initial conditions take similar configuration as that of integer order differential equations. Okay, and
excuse me, Preetam sir, I have muted everyone for a second, okay, because there was a lot of disturbance. I would like to request you to unmute yourself and then proceed.
Yes, ma'am. Or am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you. So there are wide range of applications of fractional calculus in the area of engineering, wave and diffusion study, plasma physics and biotechnology, machinery, and etc. There are so many applications, and one of the main applications which in the recent century of fractional calculus was the application of fractional calculus in sustainable development goals. So these sustainable development goals are here for the development of all the nations across the world, for improving the quality of life, the education, the poverty, etc. And the UN, the United States, has proposed 17 goals and 169 targets for a sustainable development of all the countries. And most of the goals and targets of the sustainable development goals are basically interlinked. Okay, so for example, one of the sustainable development goal is industry, innovation, infrastructure, and another sustainable development goal is climate action, decent work, and economics. So as you can actually see that there is an impact of an interrelation between a correlation between industry, innovation, infrastructure, which actually affects the climate action. So one of the utmost importance to the sustainable development goals listed in the 17 points is industrialization, and is of great significance to developing countries like India and China. So, and in these major industries, these PID controllers plays a crucial role, and it is a crucial component in this automated control process based industries due to its regulatory properties, which can synchronize temperature, pressure, and various other industrial process variables. So PID controllers are used in most automatic process control applications in industry today, and to regulate flow, temperature, pressure, etc. Okay, so basically these are actually used to regulate the flow, temperature, pressure, and other industrial process. So we'll see basically what is a PID controller. So a PID controller PID controller is proportional integral derivative controller. It is a control loop mechanism employing feedback that is widely used in industrial control systems and a variety of other applications requiring continuously modulated controller. So basically what this PID controller does, it is continuously calculates an error value which is obtained as a difference between a desired set point and the measured process variable. In this figure 1, that is the architecture of PID controller, you can see that there is an error value which is calculated as a difference between the process variable and the set which is a set point. This is about the PID controller. So it, as we have discussed, after the year 1970, there has been a wide applications of the fractional calculus in various areas, and PID controllers is one of them. So in practical terms, this PID controller actually automatically applies accurate and responsive correction to a control function. So an everyday example is the PID controller are used in major industries, cars, the normal air conditioners, fans, etc. Where the if you take specifically the example of the use of PID controllers in car, so when ascending a hill, the car actually the speed lowers there, and if only constant engine constant engine force is applied, then only it will you can actually climb a hill. So here PID controller actually restores the measured speed to the desired speed with minimum delay and overshoot by increasing the power output of the engine. Okay, so further it can actually improve the efficiency of power system and their working conditions. And there were various studies, as you can see here. The initial report of fractional PID controllers were introduced by Potlubny in 1994. And this PID, fractional order PID controller, can be actually thought of an extension of PID controller. And in PID controllers, there are only three parameters. And in the fractional order PID controller, there are actually five parameters which are to be tuned and it is denoted by pi to the power of lambda and d to the power of lambda. And lambda here is the order of fractional integration and mu is the order of fractional differentiation. And the input to the system can be given in can be seen in the equation 3. And the transfer function, as discussed by Professor Shank, actually that can be given by equation 4. So in the current research, we have found some gaps in the existing fractional order PID controllers. The first thing is the fractional order PID controller, that is in equation 3, parameters, that is the KI and KD, these parameters are not dimensionally consistent with KI and KD in PID controllers. So there is a great need to balance this mismatch, and in the current study we have proposed a new dimensionally balanced fractional order PID controller to actually address this particular gap. A novel dimensionally balanced fractional order PID controller was proposed, and the proposed fractional order controller not only helps to achieve the sustainable goals like this thing, and it can actually give much better results in comparison to the conventional PID controllers, and this can be effective to tackle the climate change, which is another sustainable development goal, which actually by minimizing the greenhouse emissions, which is a consequence of optimizing overshoot settling time and rise time. So in the current study, research, the proposed controller has been analyzed on an isolated and two area power systems. The optimized parameters of the variables affecting overshoot settling time and rise time and estimated by using the well-celebrated partial swarm optimization technique. So to evaluate the optimum values of these parameters, integral of time-weighted absolute error performance index has been used, that is ITAE, and the conventional PID AGC and the proposed DB FOPID controller are actually compared, and we have observed that this proposed PID controller yields much better results in comparison to the conventional PID controller. So as we have already seen, a PID controller consists of three components, that is KP, KI, and KD, and the fractional order PID controller has five parameters, KP, KI, KD, lambda, and mu. So this is a new dimensionally balanced fractional calculus which we propose here. So as we can see here, the coefficient of the integral and derivative, that is KI and KD, which are given in equation number 5 and equation number 6, these are the dimensions of this KI and KD are time to the power of minus lambda and time to the power of lambda, which are inconsistent with the conventional PID controller. Whereas in the fractional order PID controller, that is given by equation number 3 and equation number 5, the dimensions of KI and KD are time to the power of minus lambda and time to the power of mu. So these are actually the dimensions are mathematically inconsistent to the conventional PID controller, and to formulate and the new proposed DBFO PID controller, which are given in equation 5 and 6, are actually helps to achieve the practical design of a dimensionally balanced fractional order PID controller. So this particular fractional order PID controller is actually used in an isolated area system and as well as a two area power system. So this is the block diagram of a automatical generation control for one area system, and you can see that is this KI by S. This is only I controller. This is not PID controller. This is for this particular diagram. Says we have taken this I controller, and this I controller is replaced by PID controller, and further this is replaced by the proposed dimensionally balanced PID controller. So this is the optimization problem as we have earlier discussed. This is the optimization problem that is we have taken the ITAE of KP, KI, KD, lambda, mu, and these are actually bounded by the maximum and minimum values. In this particular study, the limits of KP, KI, and KD are taken in between minus 50 and plus 100, and the lambda and mu values will range from 0 to 2. So this is the data which we have adopted for the automatical generator control for an isolated system, and this is the response which we have obtained by using in comparison to the normal PID controller. And as you can see, this dotted line, that is this is not a FOPID controller. This is our proposed dimensionally balanced fractional order PID controller. Is the fluctuations are much less in comparison to the PID controller, and the frequency deviations or the mitigations, that is settling time, rise time, and overshoot are actually slashed by around 25%, 40%, and 15% respective, the settling time, overshoot, and rise time. And these are the values which we got for this AGC of an PID controller, and this is our results of DBFO PID controller. And these are the tuned parameters by applying the partial swarm optimization control which we got, and these are the rest time, overshoot and settling time. And this particular optimization problems can be altered, and we have actually seen that the dimensional balanced FOPID controller yields much better results in comparison to any of the conventional PID controllers. So the sensitivity analysis is also done, and these parameters, so this is tau g, and tau g are governor time constant and turbine time constant, and here h is the parameter which we have already used here, in the one area system, that is the inertia constant. This sensitivity analysis is also done by varying a particular parameter at a time, and keeping the other two parameters constants, and we have divided this into varied these particular parameters h, tau g, and tau t, and given in three particular scenarios: scenario 1, 2, and 3. And the base value has been taken to be 5.2 and 0.5, and these are varied by minus 30% to plus 30%, and it is observed that this is quite stable to the small changes which is occurred inside the power systems. And the same method is applied in the two area power systems as well. And this is the block diagram of the automatic generation control for two area power systems. And here we have, so this is the optimization problem, and the limits we have taken the same, that is minus 50 to plus 100, and the lambda and mu values are actually the upper and lower bounds are taken to be 2 and 0 respectively. And this optimization problem was optimized by using the same standard method called particle swarm optimization, and this is the data which we have taken from the Almanosh research. This is published in 2010, and these are the values. And the sensitivity analysis also done, and observed that the system is robust even to the small variation in the systems. And these are the values these are the transfer functions of P controller, that is proportional controller, PI controller, PID controller, and the proposed DBFO PID controller. These are the tuned values which we have got. And it is observed that the response of AGC for two area power systems in DBFOPID is actually yield much better results in comparison to the dimensionally balanced fractional order PID controller in an isolated controller. So by increasing the number of areas, we are actually getting much better results, and this is the summary of rise time, overshoot, and settling times of different cases of two area systems, and these are the conclusions of this particular topic. And the responses of the new fractional order PID controller, which are introduced as dimensionally balanced PID controller, is compared with the conventional PID controller. The dimensional aspect is actually addressed, and it is observed that the rise time, settling time, overshoot are reduced by 37%, 24%, and 15% respectively in isolated area. And it is further observed that in two area, so there is a significant drop in these frequency mitigations in two area power systems. So this is the observations. And with the variation, so the sensitivity analysis is also done, and it is observed that the the system is more robust as well. Yeah, so these are the observations, and I would like to thank my colleague Dr. Neelam Singha and all others, and any doubts are invited. Yeah.
Are there any questions from the participants?
Yeah.
Please feel free to ask if you have any discussion to be made, if you have any questions regarding the topic.
I have one question.
Yes, please, sir.
Is there any region for the stability?
Yes, sir. In some of the power systems, due to the variations or fluctuations of small fluctuations, the system may damage even to a small external unwanted fluctuations. So for the system to be robust, we have to do the sensitivity analysis so that to keep the system intact and use even due to the fluctuations. So, yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, welcome.
Any other questions from the participants? Okay. In that case, let me thank Dr. Pritam. Thank you so much, sir, for sharing your research work with us.